Hello friends, I'm Kanchan from Aculmec Technologies and you are welcome to Top Brass. Today we have Sitej Srivastava from Johannesburg, South Africa. And as you know, he has a deep interest in corporate training and also has a vast experience in training, marketing and IT professional in his career. So welcome to Top Brass, Sitej. How are you doing today?
I'm well, Kanchan. Thank you. And I am more and more enjoying conversing with you, and the range of subjects is really amazing.
Yeah, and we also found very interesting, and we also like to talk to you because the kind of advice and kind of opinion you provide, it is quite enlightening.
Thank you.
So as we have talking about change management, then the core idea of to get into change management, to learn change management, the pillar idea is creative thinking. Now, the creative thinking, as I said, that people talk about creative thinking. You have to think out of the box. You have to be creative with thinking. So, what are those techniques where we can develop creative thinking and come out as a winner?
So, Kanchan, creative thinking as we have been talking, and we all understand that creativity per se does not have a definite defined path. And we see creative people all the time being creative, and we just wonder, I mean, why could I not do this? Why I could not think about this? And but then in the industrialized world that we live in this industrialized world, things have to be measured, because for any creativity to be converted into a product, into a solution, somebody needs to invest money, and somebody needs to invest in the teams who develop it, and somebody needs to build a market so that people can buy it, use it. So there are several techniques of a creative thinking that is there, but I can definitely tell you whether it is 5 techniques or 10 techniques, some we will fail to find out. There could be many other techniques which we don't even know the name of, but I can tell you some of them. Something like a Guilford alternative user task. So this Guilford alternative user task is basically, it tries to measure the divergent thinking of something, flexibility. It sees how flexibility do we are in our thinking, and then it rates it with 4 parameters: fluency, originality, flexibility, and elaboration, for each of those ideas that are put forth on the table. But then there are others like they call it Wallace and Cogan creativity test, in which something that has to be the questions are around, name the things which have wheels, name the things, whether it is a car, it's a truck, it's a train, it's a cart, it's your mind. Just think about from there and then elaborate and detail it out. If we talk about something else, which is another technique, which is called a Baron Welsh art scale, it's a very flexible kind of a training, and wherein basically it requires the respondents to read or write something that they have done in any of the languages. They are asked some kind of images, they have asked some kind of write-ups, and then they are evaluated on that. Okay. There is another very interesting one, which actually really interests me a lot, is something, a creative behavior inventory. Now, when the creative behavior inventory is nothing but a list of activities, it's accomplishments that are commonly considered to be creative. For example, if we can put a question, did you write a short story? Did you write the lyrics of a song? Did you plan and presented an original speech? Did you design and made a costume? So these kind of questions can be designed by the trainer, and then based on the answers that we receive, it can be marked as, you know, never did this, did this once or twice, did this three or five times, more than five times. So we can basically look at the creative and from a pool of students, pool of children, college going students, or even the corporates, we can figure out which ideas have actually passed these kind of tests so that it can go to the further next level of evaluation, because it may be going to be a global product or a national product and it needs a lot of investment and a distribution of it. Then there is something called a Go personality scale, Torrance test of creative thinking. And these, like Torrance test, is very, very common one. And it is designed and it is identifies, evaluate creative potential using two parts. One is the verbal and one is the figural part of it. So therefore, asking, guessing, questions, sequences, we come to know about what the person has thought or a team has thought. But as I told you in the beginning, these are just some of the tests. And as you have basically figured out by the names that these are all Western techniques. And we are from India, which is known for its Jugaad, right? And therefore, Jugaad cannot have any kind of a technique. You cannot put anything under the theory called Jugaad. Though people have been writing books on Jugaad 2.0 and Jugaad 1.0, and I hear some of the European businesses in school, they are teaching Jugaad. But I must tell you one example or two examples that comes to my mind. Many years back, I had read somewhere in some newspaper that LG, you know, the Korean company, South Korean companies, LG, they were doing a market survey about how their washing machines are being used, whether they are effective for the Indian homes, for the Indian clothes and the water that comes into it. And they were doing this in Punjab. And they figured out that a washing machine is being used at the roadside dhabas to make lassi.
That is very nice.
And they were surprised. They never thought a dedicated washing machine is being used to prepare 200 glasses of lassi every day. And that washing machine is used dedicatedly to make lassi.
Okay.
And you know Delhi. In Delhi, you have seen some of the big auto rickshaws are having the motorbike engines. So you cannot put them into these techniques. But yes, these techniques help us understand and structure and figure out some of the ideas which could become really great. But again, out of all these techniques, I always feel many ideas will fall through after first layer, two layers, three layers. And as we go forward, and as we have known Steve Jobs of Apple as well.
Okay, so quite interesting, and you have quoted a quite interesting and very new kind of Jugaad examples. But coming to our core subject, is that when we teach, like as we are talking, that creative thinking has to be in the curriculum, and we as an educator would like to push this as a main subject. Not a kind of a hobby subject. It has to be main subject. So when we teach creative thinking, so what are the parameters and how we judge that the person is creative in their display of their result, and how we can push children to go into creative thinking, because the ultimate aim is that they should become a productive professional. And handle management.
I appreciate that you asked me this question. See, well, I have lived in Japan for many, many years. And I realized when I was in Japan and I observed the children growing up there and our Indian children growing up in Japan. And I, being in Japan, I also met a lot of Chinese people, Chinese families, Korean families staying in Japan. And I realized that, and then I figured out that while the child goes to the school, they introduce piano piano, learning piano in the school, and these piano learning is a graded wise, it is not a compulsory subject like a music subject, but it is a creative subject. The classification is different. In India, we have musical studies. People teach, go and learn, Indian musical instruments. But in China, in Japan, I have seen students learning piano lessons from class three or four, and they have school standards, they have city standards, they have national standards. Because if you see the piano, the keys that are there, it needs some kind of a cognitive thinking and a rhythming and threading of all of them to create a sound which is pleasure to the ears. And so China, I know for the fact, China has got a great piano lesson culture among the school and college students, because they think learning a piano, playing a piano increases the thinking and the cognitive behavior of the mind thinking alive. So that is one of the way. I'm not saying piano could be really good for Indian side. There could be other things as well. And so these are something that every educator, every education framework of the nations and countries should come up with about introducing in their countries. So as I said, Jugaad, somebody really needs to look into it and bring it into the curriculum, not from the MBA level, but probably from the school level.
So it was quite interesting to talk to you today, and we got a lot of insights, and especially your Jugaad formula, which will remain remain here. And I think the educator who will be watching this show will think about inculcating these creative techniques and they innovate and teach their student to become a finer human beings. Thank you so much, Sitesh.
Thank you.
It was lovely talking to you. Till next time.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.